Dear friends, today in revision class versus and test series, video number 2 today for old syllabus. So in this video, what we are going to do is books of accounts we are going to revise. See, this test series and revision class is only for question answers. This has nothing to do with in-depth knowledge of the sections. If somebody wants crash course, you can separately subscribe for crash course videos. That's so you can WhatsApp me. So that is totally different. Now this is revision and test series only. Now we'll go into the video. Board wants to keep the books of accounts other than its register office. Is it possible? See, the board wants to keep the books of accounts other than the register office. As per section 128, whenever the company wants to keep the books of accounts outside the register office, they have to pass a board resolution and it should be intimated to ROC within 7 days. Next. So is it possible? Yes, it is possible. They have to intimate ROC after passing board resolution. Can company keep the books of accounts in cash basis? As per section 128, company have to keep the books of accounts only in accrual basis and double entry format. So they cannot keep it in cash basis. Next question. Director appointed charter accountant to inspect the books of accounts of the company. Can they do so? See, inspection of the books can be done by directors themselves. Inspection of books by agent appointed by the director needs board resolution. If the holding company director wants subsidiary company's books to be inspected, that is also possible. Okay, by passing board resolution in both holding and subsidiary company. But in that scenario, you cannot appoint agent. This is given in section 128 itself. Can a member of a company do inspection? As per section 128, the member doesn't have any rights to inspect the books of accounts. See, you would have studied in IPSC that member has a right to do inspection. But those things are registers and not books of accounts. Here we are talking about books of accounts. So, inspection of books of accounts is not allowed as per section 128. But in case if the articles of association provides, then inspection of books of accounts is also possible for members. In case if they adopted table F of schedule 1 directly. So, there is a regulation, I think it's 89 or so. It is allowing members to do inspection of books of accounts provided after passing a ordinary resolution in the general meeting. Next question. Accounting standard has not been followed in preparing the financial statements. What is the liability of directors and auditors? See, accounting standard is mandatory. Under section 133, every company has to follow accounting standard while preparing books of accounts and financial statements. Now, if it has not been followed, it should be disclosed in notes to accounts. What is the level of deviation, etc. Now, it is the duty of the directors who signs the financial statements and board report. They have to disclose the facts in board report and financial statements. As an auditor, you have to qualify your audit opinion. Then, so that is 143. Auditor's duty will come under 143. Director's duty will come under 129 read with 134. Should a company consolidate the accounts of the foreign subsidiary also? As per section 129, subsidiaries, if they have, they have to do consolidation of financial statements. So subsidiary includes foreign subsidiary also. So we have to do consolidation of financial statements, whether it is Indian subsidiary or foreign subsidiary. Even subsidiary includes the term associates and joint venture under section 129. So hence you have to do consolidation. When you do consolidation CFS, you have to use AOC 4-CFS for filing with ROC under section 136. Then who has to sign the financial statement in case of normal company and 1% company? In case of normal company, under section 134 of the Companies Act, if it is a public limited company, then In case if the company has a chairperson, he has to sign. If there is no chairperson, in case if there is an MD, MD has to sign. Okay. If there is no MD, at least two directors has to sign. In case the company has CFO, then CFO is mandatory to sign. If the company has CEO, the CEO has to mandatorily sign. CS has to sign. Okay. See, in today's scenario, private limited company, at least two directors has to sign. In today's scenario, we are having one person company also. One person company, even if it is one director signs, it's enough. Can unadopted annual accounts be filed with ROC? See, unadopted annual accounts can be filed with ROC, that's called provisional accounts. And once it is adopted, it's called final accounts. But the question, if they ask unaudited financial statements, that cannot be filed. So unadopted can be filed, but unaudited cannot be filed. The next thing is, which companies are required to constitute CSR committee? State the duties of CSR committee. See, CSR committee, when it is applicable, in case if the company, any company, okay, either it is a private company or public company, including if they have turnover of 1,000 crores, okay, net worth of 500 crores, or net profit of 5 crores, then CSR committee has to be constituted with 3 directors. And if you have independent director in your company applicability, if you have section 149 subsection 4 applicable for your company, then the CSR committee should also have one independent director. Then CSR committee will be recommending the activities based from schedule 7 activities. Okay, then what is the amount to be spent? 2% of average net profit of last 3 years. That is the amount to be spent. In case if there is a losses in the last 3 years, any one of the years in losses, you should see the average. What is the maximum amount to be spent for CSR employees and agencies? What are all activities for which CSR is not possible? See, in case if you have CSR applicability and you will be spending, say, 2% of your net profits average of last 3 years, maximum 5% of the 2% can be used for employees. Okay, not more than that. But political contribution is not possible. Contribution to a foreign activities is not possible. Then the next question, contribution to promote sanitation facilities and clean Ganga projects, etc., whether it contributes to CSR. See, I will tell you, contribution to coronavirus also, okay, is now added to CSR. So clean Ganga, Swachh Bharat, everything is CSR activities only. Then company kept the books of accounts outside the register office, they passed the board resolution, they failed to inform ROC. See, once the board resolution is passed, that's enough. But if ROC you have not intimated, if you are going to intimate delay, then you have to pay 100 rupees per day as additional fees under section 403 of the Companies Act. Then contents of director responsibility statement. Director responsibility statement will include point number 1, that they are responsible for maintaining going concern, that accounting standard will be consistently applied, accounting policies are consistently applied, and accounting standards are properly followed. Preparation of financial statements is true and fair, and they have complied with accounting standards and schedule 3. Safeguarding of assets, prevention and reduction of fraud and error, implementation of internal control, compliance with laws and regulations. These are the points to be kept in mind for director's responsibility statement. Next question, who can inspect the books of accounts of the company? The books of accounts of the company can be inspected by point number 1, directors of the company. Point number two, agents appointed by the directors after passing board resolution. Point number three, shareholders in case ordinary resolution in general meeting is passed. Point number four, SEBI in case the company is listed. Point number five, NCLT. Okay, so in case if it is requested. Point number six, central government. So these many people can inspect the books of accounts. It is not there in particular section, it is there in so many sections. I am just linking it and I am giving to you. Sir, inspection by central government, NCLT, those things are comes under 210, 212, 213. Okay, even SFIO will come. Okay, serious fraud investigation officer, that also you can add here. Then shareholder, all directors, agents are 128. Then a public company having paid up capital 80 crores, turnover 110 crores. Whether internal audit is mandatory. Public company, if having turnover of 200 crores or loans exceeding 100 crores or capital, equity capital of 50 crores or deposits of 25 crores, then internal audit is applicable. In this question, paid up capital they mentioned is 80 crores, hence internal audit is applicable. So who has to do internal audit? What is his qualification? Internal audit should be done by a chartered accountant or a cost accountant or any other professional as the board may think fit. So his qualification is this, and audit committee or the board of directors will be appointing the internal auditors. Who will formulate the scope for internal audit? Audit committee or the board of directors, as the case may be. Next, borrowing of a private company is rupees 100 crores. Is it mandatory to appoint internal auditor? In case private limited company borrow exactly 100 crores, they are asking. So the question, if it asks exceeding 100 crores, the answer is different. Yes, internal audit is applicable. If the question is exactly 100 crores, then internal audit is not applicable. Company delayed in filing annual accounts with ROC. What is the penalty? See, when the company is delaying beyond 30 days from the date of AGM for filing annual accounts, AOC 4, or beyond 60 days for annual return, MGT 7, then per day 100 rupees per form is the additional fees. So now they are not imposing penalty like 50,000 rupees etc, but this additional fees itself is coming in lakhs if you delay, because every day it starts like 200 rupees per so AOC 400 and MGT 7 another 100. No, see, now LLP they give one amnesty scheme that the maximum is 5,000 rupees. People yet to utilize those schemes. I don't know for when companies it will come. I don't think for companies they will give. Next, the company has three directors, out of which one is MD. Company has CFO also. Now who and all should sign the financial statements under section 134? I told you already this, so I am going to skip this question. CSR committee recommended an activity which required 5% of the average net profit of the last 3 years. Can the excess spent be adjusted in the future years? Answer is, if you spend short, you have to spend within 2-3 years. Now it's added now in the amendment. But if you spend extra, you cannot carry forward and all. If you spend short, you have to disclose in the board report the reason and that you will be spending within next 3 years. XBRL form, which company has to file? If it's company both private and public, if they are listed, it is mandatory. Private and public, if their paid up capital is 5 crores or more, turnover is 100 crores or more, then they have to file XBRL form. But XBRL is not applicable for banking, okay, this NBFC, financial institutions, electricity companies, okay, those people and all, XBRL is not applicable. Next, company having paid up capital 65 crores appointed a CA as CFO. Company also has CEO. and he wants to appoint internal auditor, can the CFO himself be a internal auditor for the company? See, I'll tell you, CFO, if he is a chartered accountant, he can also do internal audit. Why not? It is not necessary that external person should be there. No, employee can do internal audit, so they can be internal auditor also. Next, in case the next question asking, they are asking this: the company's profit depends on foreign branch profit. The Indian branch is making loss, only the foreign branch is making profit. Whether, and the turnover is more than say 1000 crores, whether CSR is applicable? Answer is no, because you have to see only Indian branch profit and not the foreign branch profit. CSR is not applicable. Next, sorry, CSR is applicable, but they need not spend CSR for. Next question: company spends 1.10% of average net profit of last 3 years, even when the CSR is not applicable for them. Their absurdity is their wish. They need not even spend CSR. If they are spending even 1 rupee, it's okay, no issue. If the financial statements does not comply with AS accounting standards, what do you have to do? Give 10 notes to accounts, qualify the audit report. Can central government exempt from consideration of financial statement of certain companies? Yes, possibility is there. Central government can do. They have all these powers. Last 3 years profit they have given, and they will calculate you to do CSR spending activities, and they will ask you penalty for not spending CSR activities. So this question, this kind of questions will come. Then, listed company wants to circulate financial statement in electronical form. See, listed companies, they can do this electronic PDF circulation of financial statements. Instead of even circulating the full financial statement, they can upload the full financial statement in the website and give only abridged financial statement. That is allowed. Listed company can do. Public company having net worth of 1 crore and turnover of 10 crores can also do PDF form of financial statements. Absolutely no issue. Next, can independent director sign the financial statements? It is not necessary, but if they want, the board wants, then independent director is also okay, then he can sign. Central government asked NCLT to reopen the books of accounts. So, is it possible for them? Point number two, if the board wants to reopen themselves, can they do? See, if NCLT wants to reopen the books of accounts, generally central government or SEBI or income tax authority will complain to NCLT to reopen the books of accounts. And they can reopen for a period of 8 years. For a period of 8 years. And in case investigation is pending for long period, they can reopen even beyond that 8 years. This is point number one. Then the next point, this is given in section 130. The next question is section 131, voluntary revision by the board of directors. Yes, the board can also do voluntary revision of financial statements for a period of 3 years, and they can approach the NCLT. Once the revision is approved by NCLT, they can do the revision of financial statement. Okay, then they have to do, in both the scenarios, they have to get it re-audited and they have to call EGM. They have to get it adopted by passing order resolution in general meeting with shareholders, and they have to refile AOC 4 to ROC. So these are the maximum possible examination questions that can be asked from this books of accounts chapter. I hope this video is helpful for you. Now you can start writing the test for the books of accounts question.